Hello student, in this video we will study about the molecular and electron pair domain geometries for AB2 type of molecules. And if you remember in the previous slide, we have studied that there are five different type of molecular and pair electron pair geometry we have to study. So this is the first we are going to study, AB2 type, which have usually central atom at the center and two other elements are around it. So the first example is the hydrogen, but it does not comes into AB2 type because it's there is no third atom. If there is only for the diatomic molecule, usually they also comes in this type of category. So first we have to draw the structure and then see if any diatomic species is a linear in the geometry. A linear geometry has 180 degree bond angle. So all the diatomic molecule, if they do not have any non-bonding electrons, they have a linear geometry. And so this is important, linear geometry and 180 degree bond angle. Another example is carbon dioxide, CO2. So this is also type of AB2 type of molecule, where A is the central atom as a carbon and two oxygen are bonded by the double bond with the carbon. And again, so you will see this type of table in many other slides, and this is very good table for memorizing and learning about the molecular geometry and electron pair geometry. So you can see the number of electron domain, number of electron domains are the two, which is they are considering these domain which are in the bonding, which are bonded carbon and oxygen. So number of electron domain two means these two electron domain means electron pairs. So electron domain geometry is linear because there are two only, and bonding domain two, there are two bonding domains, and non-bonding domain is zero. If you have to count non-bonding, we are only talking about the central atom, not the other atom. So in that case, molecular geometry will be linear. Electron domain geometry will be linear and molecular geometry will also be linear. So, and this is an example for carbon dioxide, where it says two atoms are bonded to central atom and no non-bonding electrons on the central atom, and the linear geometry will be, and the bond angle between these two will be 180 degree. So this was about the carbon dioxide gas. So the molecular geometry is the same as the electron pair geometry if there are no non-bonding electrons on the central atom. This is very important. If no non-bonding electrons on the central atom, always you have to see if the central atom have any extra non-bonding or electron or not. If you can see non-bonding electrons on the oxygen or nitrogen which are not in the central atom, then don't worry about that one. They are not influencing the shape of the 3D shape of the molecule. And if there are non-bonding electrons on the central atom, you must count the number of things around the central atom to determine the electron pair geometry. So we will see this type of with non-bonding electron pair in the some other examples. So this is the second type of geometry, which is called AB3 type of geometry. An example is BF3SO2 and NO2 ion. So first we have to draw the Lewis dot structure for this molecule. And once you will draw the Lewis dot structure, you will notice that there are the three atoms bonded to the central atom. 1, 2, 3. And boron do not have any extra electron pair as a non-bonding atom. So the trigonal planar molecular geometry will be there, and the three bonds will be at 120 degree. So basically they will be like that, not exactly like this, because this look like there will be 180 degrees. So they will be in this form, trigonal, and the molecular geometry will be the same as the electron pair geometry, which is called trigonal planar molecule. And each bond and the bond angle between these two will be 120 degree. So this was the first example about the AB3 type without any non-bonding electron pair. Let's see another example where sulfur dioxide. So you can see the sulfur dioxide, when you draw the Lewis dot structure, sulfur have one extra lone pair. So what is, how we have to summarize this, that there are two atoms bonded to a center atom and non-bonding electron on the central atom. So one non-bonding electron pair on the central atom is there, and angular molecular geometry will be there. So, and molecular geometry is not same as the electron pair geometry. So what will happen, sulfur, and we can write like this one, double bond like this one, and sulfur, sorry, this will be oxygen, and the electron pair geometry non-bonding electron will be like this one. So we have to draw the, and these non-bonding electron pair give a repulsion, exert a repulsive force on these bonding electrons from both sides. That is why this molecule, its shape is called the bend, angular bent molecule. But if you will forget about the remove all the atoms here, so what will happen, if you still they have electron pair, so this is the electron pair of geometry, which is trigonal planar. So electron pair geometry will be still trigonal planar, but molecular shape will be different, which is less than. So let's review one more time with this one. So three things around the central atom, two atoms bonded to a central atom, one non-bonding electron pair on the central atom, and angular molecular geometry. So this shape will of the sulfur dioxide will be which is called angular shape. So the shape of this electron sulfur dioxide will be angular, and the electron pair geometry will, but still electron pair geometry will remain trigonal planar, and the bond angle will be 120 degree. So let's summarize these with this picture with the table. So in case of AB3 type, number of electron pair, electron domain will be 3, 1, 2, 3, the central atom, and this is showing that electron domain geometry is 3. And if there is no non-bonding electron on the central atom, then the molecular geometry will also be same, trigonal planar. Example BF3, boron trifluoride. But if there is one lone pair or non-bonding domain is there, which is we have seen in case of SO2 and also in case of nitrate ion NO2 also. So this lone pair of electron is bigger or occupy larger space than the bonding electron, and it exert more repulsion between these two electrons. That is why this molecular shape changes from trigonal planar to bent molecule. So these were the two types of the AB2 type and AB3 type of example, and we will see next is AB4 type of. So let's review about the AB4 type of. In case of AB4 type of geometry, the methane, ammonia, and water is example. You can see in case of water, it does not look that look like AB4 type, but we will see how it comes in case of AB4 4 type. So when we will draw the Lewis structure for CH4, so you can see the four atoms bonded to the central atom and no non-bonding electrons on the central atom. And so therefore tetrahedral molecular geometry will be there. So if you again review this one, so we have studied so far AB2 type, AB3 type and AB4 type. So in case of AB4 type, the electron pair geometry and molecular shape will remain same as a tetrahedron if there is no non-bonding electron on the central atom. So molecular geometry is the same as the electron pair geometry, which is tetrahedron. But when any non-bonding electron pair will be involved, then the molecular shape will change. For an example, in case of ammonia, you can see ammonia, when you will draw the Lewis dot structure, you will notice that there are three bonds which are bonded to the nitrogen, and the fourth remaining two electrons or one electron pair or electron domain which is non-bonding will remain as such on the central atom. So there are three atoms bonded to the central atom, one non-bonding electron on the central atom, which is this one, and therefore the trigonal pyramidal molecular geometry will be there. And molecular geometry is not the same as the electron pair geometry. So what will be the electron pair geometry? You may have to remember that they are coming in the AB4 type of molecule, and in case of AB4 type of molecule, three atoms bonded to the central atom. So four things around the central atom. What are the four things around the central atom? Nitrogen, one lone pair electron, and one hydrogen which is attached with the nitrogen, another hydrogen and another hydrogen. So there are four things. If we do not involve the atoms in this picture, so what will we can write like this one, we can also write like this, lone pair of electron, and these are the three things. So and here it will be our central atom. So if there are four things around the central atom, so the electron pair geometry will be tetrahedron and the bond angle will be 109 degree, but the molecular shape, molecular geometry will change because this non-bonding electron will exert a repulsive force between these one and they become bent. So the shape is called the trigonal pyramidal molecular geometry will be trigonal by molecular geometry will be trigonal pyramidal. So molecular geometry is not same as the electron pair geometry. So if we summarize these in the form of table, so here is the table that says that number of electron domain are four. So if the four electron domains are there, so geometry of electron domain will be tetrahedron, and if there is no non-bonding, so molecular shape will also be tetrahedron, for an example methane CH4. But if there is one lone pair that exert extra force on these bonds, and the molecular shape will become trigonal pyramidal, and the example is ammonia NH3. In case of if there is two non-bonding electrons are there, for an example water molecule, which have you can see there are two lone pair electrons are there which are non-bonding, one is here, one is here, and two bonding are there. So these two non-bonding electrons, they exert a lot of repulsive force on the bonding electrons. That is why the molecule shape or molecular geometry is changes from trigonal pyramidal to bent one. So in case of AB4 type, electron geometry will always remain for all 3 or any other example as a tetrahedron, but the molecular geometry will change. So let's summarize one more way that if one things around the central atom, if only one thing is, the linear. If the two things are there, linear. If the three things will be there, trigonal planar. If four things will be there, then tetrahedron. So this is the electron pair geometry, which is you can also say see like this one, that one thing like hydrogen and hydrogen, so only one thing is here, two things are here around the central atom, here three things are there, and here four things are there. So this was the overview about the electron pair geometry, that how we will count that if how many things are there around the central atom. And if atoms around the central atom is one, so linear. If atoms are two, then it's still linear. If two atoms, but the possible geometry could be linear or angular. In case of three things, then possible geometry would be trigonal planar and trigonal pyramidal also. In case of four, so tetrahedron will be there, and the other geometries were also possible. So things to remember, which is molecular geometry and electron pair geometries are the same only if there are no non-bonding electrons on the central atom. If central atom do not have any non-bonding electron pair, then molecular geometry and electron pair geometry will remain same. But the bond angle and the bond angle of the molecule are determined by the electron pair geometry. And when counting things around the central atom, everything count as regardless of what it is. And all of the examples so far have either followed the octet rule or had less than the octet around the central atom. So these were the example for AB 2 type, AB 3 type, and AB 4 type. And in the next video, we will study about the AB 5 type of geometry and electron pair geometries.